Hi, today's video is gonna be about how and why cavities form. You ever wondered why some people get cavities and other people don't? Things like that. I'm gonna answer all those questions for you today. You know, we really want our patients to be well-educated because I feel that a well-educated patient is a healthy patient. So the first thing you need to know about cavities is that there's a lot of different factors that affect who gets cavities, who gets worse cavities, and things like that. There is some role of genetics that plays, you know, into how many cavities that people can get. But I'm a firm believer that all cavities can be prevented, even if you have a whole family history of cavities. If you're really well educated about how to prevent cavities and how to take care of your teeth, then we can definitely prevent cavities. Definitely refer to our other video about how to brush and floss and really take care of your mouth, because that's also very important in preventing cavities. But in this video, I actually want to give you the science behind why a cavity forms. So what happens, right? What are cavities exactly? And this is gonna sound kind of nasty, but you eat sugar. There's bacteria in your mouth, and they eat this sugar, and they poop out acid, right? I know that sounds disgusting, but that's really what it is. It's bacteria poop eating away at your teeth. So what happens is you have bacteria living on your teeth, right? And they're there, and there's not much we can do about it. But let's say this black is all bacteria, and there's some bacteria in the grooves on the top of your teeth. I'm sure some of you, you know, if you look in the mirror at your back teeth, you'll notice that there's lines and grooves in there. And those actually go way deeper than they seem. Another place that bacteria often live is between your teeth, which is why flossing between your teeth is very important, right? But there's always a little bit of bacteria between your teeth. So what happens is you have sugar. These bacteria eat the sugar and they put out acid. And over time, the cavity forms. And usually these are the most common types of cavities a dentist will see. Either a cavity in the top of a tooth, eating in from the tooth from the top down, or cavities between teeth. We call them kissing cavities because usually when there's one, there's actually two, and one causes another. So over time, the bacteria just keep eating away at the tooth. The acid, the bacteria may keep eating away at the tooth and causing these big cavities. And eventually they get into the nerve, which is in the middle of the tooth, and cause a lot of pain, and eventually you may end up needing even more treatment than just fixing the cavity. Now the things that make people more susceptible to cavities, right, which I want you to know, is it's not necessarily the amount of sugar that you have as much as the frequency of sugar. So parents, if you're watching this with your kids, maybe cover their ears real quick because I'm gonna say something and, you know, they're gonna hold you to it. But it's actually, as far as teeth are concerned, not your whole body, it's safer to eat a whole bag of candy and then immediately brush your teeth and floss and rinse than it is to eat one piece every 10 minutes and only finish maybe, you know, 1/5 of that whole bag of candy, right? So you can have 5 times as much candy, but as long as you brushed and flossed and cleaned your teeth, you may not be at high risk of cavities as a person who's having a piece of candy every 10 minutes. That's not to say that you should go out and eat a whole bag of candy. There's a whole host of other problems that can happen to your body with that much sugar and all that stuff. So please don't do that. Please don't. So that's the first thing that can cause cavities. Now the second thing, right, is just sipping on anything that has sugars in it or any sort of actually carbohydrate like potato chips. So potato chips are a starch, right? Potatoes, crackers, flour, those are all starches, which eventually in the body actually get broken down to sugars. So what can happen is potato chips, I'm sure you guys have had potato chips that just stick in your teeth, in the back of your teeth, right? That sticks right here. So eventually what happens, the potato chip is sitting there and the bacteria slowly break it down and eventually break it into sugar and then they break it into acid. So you gotta start thinking about carbohydrates as well, the ones that can turn into sugar, and things like sipping juices all day long, sipping soda all day long, sipping coffee with sugar in it, you know, anything like that. Any frequent exposure to sugar or any of the carbohydrates that turn into sugar causes cavities. So it's not a matter of amount, it's a matter of frequency when it comes to cavities. So definitely keep that in mind going forward. If you know, sugar is great. I love candy myself too. I don't eat a lot of it as a dentist, but it's about how much you have and then you just brush real quick versus just, you know, snacking on all day long. That's gonna cause a lot more cavities. You know, so I hope this video helped you. I hope this helps prevent some cavities, and we'll see you next time.